I'm back. Okay, I'm back.
Yeah, that's a great way to start it. This is relatable. The out of breath one is Angela. The one just sitting here is me, Dylan.
Let's start with that.
Hold on.
Wait, okay. Coming in and shalosh, niham, halom.
First off, that's racist. I don't think you can.
They say it on Christina P's. I just don't know what they're saying.
Well, they're Jewish and they're counting in.
I know. So I just don't know what it is. Hebrew. I got to learn it.
It's one, like 3, 2, 1 or 1, 2, 3. Yeah. They're just counting
shalom,
it off.
Shalom, halosh, shalom.
That's definitely not right.
I'm going to look it up. I'll get it next time. Trisha, I'm going to make you proud.
Actually, maybe it's, yeah, I don't know. Anyway.
Episode 13.
Welcome to the show.
Lucky 13.
We're 13s. Look at that. Our episodes are finally teenagers. Woo.
Woo. 13. I can't believe it.
I know.
Well, I've got all kinds of stuff lined up for you today, Ed, more than I thought I did. But I don't know if you want to kick this off or how you want to go.
I mean, I can kick it off, but it's going to be,
Okay. Do you want me to give you like my one thing to
give
start
me,
off?
Yeah.
On
give me like
end?
one, maybe two, and then I'll take over the rest.
Okay. I'll get
so
you warm.
Stoked.
Let me get us warmed up. Okay.
Okay.
Here we go. So Dylan, you know, we still don't have a number one queen yet.
We don't have a queen. Where are queen?
We don't have a number one queen. Where are my queens at? You got to email us. First one to email at relatablewardartypodcast@gmail.com gets
Come
to be
on.
Head queen.
I'm looking at you. You want to be a queen.
Be our queen. Well, I was thinking about the other day and I'm like, I've never heard anyone use this. Like, is it even a word? So I looked it up. And here
oh,
is
no.
what.
Queen is a word?
Oh, it's a word, Dylan. And according Shit. To Urban Dictionary, Shit. a queen. I want to see your face. Let me
what
move this out of the way of seeing your reaction. What a queen is the part of the human body in between a male's sexual reproductive organ and his testicles. This part usually gathers the most sweat and tends to smell. It can also be a derogatory term used to describe someone. So, example one, Blake Porter has the nastiest queen I have ever seen. It was hairy and looked like Chewbacca and Yoda had a baby. Example two, Joey Padilla's queen can only be described as rat-like. I don't think those are the best examples.
Read the first part again, because I need to hear that.
Basically, it's the taint. The part of the human body between a male's sexual reproductive organ and his testicles. Wait, is that a
no.
taint? No, that's
so
between
that's,
there. Oh, wait, so that's between...
So it's
I don't
so
know.
It's where, it's where the boys are connected to the shaft. That is the queen.
Ew.
Okay.
That's a queen, apparently. That's so that's queen. Urban Dictionary. I mean,
so you want to be my queen? Email
be,
us in.
Be my queen. What is Merriam-Webster? Does Merriam-Webster have anything to say on it? Because sometimes Urban Dictionary, I just don't
tattoo,
know. You know what
I'll
mean?
I'll tattoo your name on my queen.
Be my queen. Be my queen. Now, Merriam-Webster is not showing me anything.
Yeah, of course not, because it's not a word. It's a slang word, apparently.
It's look up popularity of that word is in the top 19% of words.
That's all me.
Right?
You're welcome.
And then it says, what made you want to look up queen? Please tell
Dylan.
Us where you read or heard it, including a quote, if possible. Can we submit?
Say,
can
do
we
it,
submit?
Do it. Do it.
For the Rodarte podcast said
yeah,
that I could be the
Rodarte.
Head queen.
Relatable Rodarte podcast. And then they can just read out our text messages that we had going
oh
back
gosh.
And forth where I say that.
Okay, like, we're going to submit a definition to, I'll do this on my off time.
To Merriam-Webster's?
Submit a definition to Merriam-Webster. Because if we can make queen in Merriam-Webster, that is like the ultimate.
You know how many friends I will have that will be upset by that idea, because there were always words that that like people would say that for the fun of it I'd always be like, oh yeah, no, that's totally a real word. And they'd be like, no, it's not a real word. If it shows up, yeah, on what the heck website did you just find that on? Urban Dictionary.
That was
they're
on
like
Urban,
that doesn't
Urban Dictionary.
They're like, Urban Dictionary doesn't count as a credible like dictionary-ish type source. Like, is it in Merriam-Webster? Is it in, I don't remember. There was always like one other one they would go to. because I think the main one we would always argue about was call was the word remastery. It was remastery, or I think it was remastery.
Remastery.
Because there's, you know, there's been so many like movies and video games that have been remastered recently, and one of our friends would always throw around the word remastery. Like, he's like, oh yeah, I'm totally gonna go pick up the remastery of that. And we're just like, is that a real word? Like, there was a very big long debate about that. And for the fun of it, I was always just like, yeah, no, that's totally a word.
Remastery. Well, right now we're talking about the word queen. Wait 1 second though. On definitions.net, it says queen as a noun is a noun, means pleasure. Queen as a verb means to be pleasing to someone or something. Queen as a verb, to satisfy and to assuage. How to say queen in sign language?
Assuage? No. Who gives a shit about sign language? No offense. Say that other word. Say that other word.
Assuage. I wish my pants were made of assuage instead of suede. Q U E E M.
Ooh, aren't you freaking cool? You can make hand signs. What are you, a Naruto watcher? Get out of here.
But queen, I don't know, man. I don't know. If we can get in like Wikipedia, that would be it. That would be it right there.
I wish my memory was longer. Say that one, that other word again. I like that other word.
Assuage.
See, I like that word. I like that word now.
More than queen?
Queen's out. Assuage is in.
You want to be my assuage? You're going to have to work on that one.
I'll find a way.
Can I assuage you to be my queen?
Can I assuage you to be my queen?
Even though that's not how it is. Can I assuage you?
Can I assuage you?
To be my queen.
Are you using that word right? Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Can I assuage you to be my queen?
Can I assuage you to believe that I'm using it the right way? No, apparently not.
Apparently not. Well, yeah, I had to let you know. I looked it up and I was like, WTF, dude.
That's great.
But if you want me to give you one more, there's something that we do need to talk about here.
Uh-oh, what happened?
It is what the fuck is wrong with Zac Efron's face?
What do you mean?
Did you see this? Look it. Do you see that? Do you see how much work he got done? Look it.
Oh, buddy, no.
Look at how handsome he was. He was a little too pretty for me. How handsome. And how he is looking botched.
Too pretty.
Too pretty. I don't like boys that are too pretty.
Mm-mm. Is it the hair lightening or whatever that's called?
I just don't think that someone like this looks intimidating enough to protect me.
Well, yeah, and then you see him pop that shirt off and you're like, holy shit, this man's rocking like a 12-pack.
What, the 12-pack that he went to get cool sculpting for that he didn't have to actually work for? I don't know.
Hold on. Hold on. You don't just just get a freaking six pack like that. Like, that is work and dedication. Let me tell
Hollywood
you.
Hollywood is magic.
Yeah, magic as in money magic. Like getting a
trainer. They also have a little money help. Like, that's
sit there
and
they whip
he's
them.
He's handsome. He's just
and they make
kidding.
Sure that he's eating the right food all the time. He's not allowed to leave the building. Like, they just sit there and they whip him and they're like, more squats, more thrusts.
Keep going.
Yeah. They're like, yeah. They're like, did you think about an Oreo just now? Yeah. And they whip him and he's just like, ah. They're like, it's all broccoli, fish,
broccoli,
chicken breast. They just whip him and he's just like, ah, until he just looks perfect. And then they're
like, that's what happened to him.
Yeah. And then they let him go on set. They let him go on set for like 20 minutes and then they bring him back and they start whipping him again. That's how that works.
Well, this guy deserves to have his face whipped, because
I mean, he looked,
he actually looks... whipped it himself. So it's in this, I'll show you the video clip that this is from, but people went and they found the worst moments to pause just, on it. Just, but
they just popped his jaw out more, or not his jaw, his,
it looks to me, and I am not an expert by any means, but it looks to me like homeboy got some filler.
His cheeks look a little swollen.
He's got filler up in his cheeks underneath his eyes. I would say that I would assume that he has filler in his lips, which honestly, look, I'm sorry, dudes. I just don't think straight guys should be getting filler in their lips. Like, gay guys can pull it off. Anybody should be getting
filler in their lips.
I get them in mine, and I love it.
I know, but, and I'm just like, eh. Why bother?
I don't want to shame him, but I'm just saying it's gone too far. Like,
you're
going to
shame him for something you got
face.
Yourself?
Well, I haven't gone too far.
Oh, what,
look at this beautiful specimen before you.
Far?
What is too far?
Oh, hold on. Get that one of him, that big open smile. That's a good photo.
Which one?
No. What are you doing? Go back to the other one. Go back to the, oh, yeah, it's right there. See it? No. It's, yeah. Look at that. Look how happy he looks.
That is a handsome man. It's a handsome man. But that is a man stuck in turmoil, thinking about what he did to his face.
It makes him look very different.
It makes him look so old. Like,
it almost makes him look like he's an alcoholic or something, like the puffiness of his face.
Dude, he's gonna end up looking like? He's gonna end up looking like Mickey Rourke. Like, he's going to end up looking like all of these old botched ass dudes of Hollywood. Like botched Hollywood men. He's going to start to show up on this page. There's Mickey Rourke. Who else have we got? Mickey Rourke. I mean, Tom Cruise shouldn't be on here. He doesn't look.
I like whatever happened to his teeth.
Hey, Wayne Newton looks like an old woman now, but he's never been cute. No, Gosling looks fine. I don't know why.
Seven Hollywood hunk men that you didn't know got plastic surgery.
He's going to start showing up on here, though. I mean, he's got to be careful what he's doing. Here we go. I mean, I don't.
Show up on where? Why do I care about Pinterest.com?
I'm just saying, so here's the video. He's talking to Bill Nye, the science guy, about like Earth Day or something. This is from Daily Mail. Get this out.
He doesn't
of here.
Even look that bad, like in this still right there.
No, so that's what I'm saying. They picked like the worst stills that really like show
emphasize
the worst of it. But
Zac Efron shows off his chiseled jawline in new photo promoting his Netflix show after sparking plastic surgery rumors with new look.
Mm-hmm. It's,
oh, okay.
You know, he's talking to Justin Bieber at first, and I don't know what Justin Bieber has to do with Earth Day, but
it doesn't even look like Zac Efron is in the. Okay,
Zac Efron. Doesn't even look like Zac Efron is in this. Okay, hold on. Here he is.
Broadway musical spectacular, Bill. Wow. I knew you were smart, but I think you're a genius,
dude. I think.
Oh,
well, now
shit.
It doesn't.
Fortune Feimster. That's what's up.
Did you notice when I paused it during his segment, it went to that screen of other screens, and then I paused it on her and it stayed on her so that people can't pull up clips probably.
Oh, maybe.
What?
Fortune Feimster is hilarious. You should go check out her stand up and stuff.
Yeah.
Big fan.
So I'm just saying. I don't know, man. It's not good. He needs to,
I mean,
but luckily.
Whatever. See, that's what happens when you start talking all this shit about Zac Efron. The world,
okay, but hey,
Zac comes back to you.
How about on the next episode, I'll write this down on my list of things to do. I will show you. I do have a couple pictures from when I know.
Send him an email and let him know that when I get all the rest of my shots, that me and him can go hang out, and I'll interview him about all of this plastic surgery stuff. and then, you know, we'll just hang out and get a beer and stuff. And then I'll be like,
okay, I'll tell him because I clearly have connections to him. Yeah, obviously. I'll let him know for you.
Tell the people you used to work with, let them know that, like, me and Zac Efron.
Someone's got to know Zac.
Yeah. It'll be cool. We'll be best friends.
The good news that I have is
it's
not too late.
Love you, man.
Zachary, cool. It is not too late. Zachariah, cool dog. Zacharu, it's not too late. You can get things to dissolve the stuff in your face, or you can just let it go naturally. If you're not ready to say goodbye, I'm sure you spent a lot of money on it. Just, am I pausing? Am I freezing?
You're chipping a little bit, but that's okay. Basically, you what she's trying me? To
just
say
let it
is,
go. Just let it go.
It's okay, man. Like, if you need a good hug and a beer and a cry, because, you know, the pressures of Hollywood and that lifestyle are getting to you, I'm right here. I got you.
Basically, like Moses said to the Pharaohs, let my filler go.
Let your filler
go. Let it
go.
Let my filler go. That is what your face is saying to the world. Let my filler go. And I'll bring up, because I'll admit, I went a little hog wild with it when I was getting it done at first. I have a couple pictures where I can tell that my lips were a little overdone.
It was when you were tired of looking like, you were tired of looking like Marilyn Manson.
Yeah, when I was tired of looking like Marilyn. He has bird lips.
Yeah, exactly. Not nice full lips.
I was tired of looking like Marilyn Manson, so I got my lips done so that no one would get us confused anymore. And it worked. Except apparently it doesn't work with online
not at all
tests that match your face with things.
It knows. It's like, let's try. Let's we know what try. You really look like,
you fool.
Marilyn Manson look alike.
Well, I have one more for you if you're ready for it, and then I'll release the reins. So this apparently, okay, let me read you from this article first. Have you heard about how, like, Tom Brady apparently, like, kisses his family members on the lips?
No, but
I don't know how I haven't heard of this. So, like, there's families that do that, right? Some family, and, like, hey, if that's your thing, I get it. Me,
I
personally,
don't.
It's not for me.
You can say you get it, but I don't get it.
I've seen, like when, like, little kids are little and, like, a mom will, like, kiss her daughter and, like, oh, like, I don't know. I mean, I guess... I don't know. It's not for me. It's not for me.
It's not for me either.
Personally, like I don't, I can get just as much out of a peck on the cheek from my mom and a big old hug. I feel like I get more out of hugs. You know what I mean? Like a good hug.
I was going to say, I don't think I like,
you don't need a kiss. A kiss doesn't even give you an embrace all the time.
I give mom a hug. Like, yeah, I don't think I ever like give her a kiss on the cheek or anything anymore. Like,
oh, that's sad.
What do you mean aw?
I give her kisses on the cheek.
I just give people hugs. I don't know. That's not, because that just seems odd. It's like too much work too. I don't know. The whole idea
to go like this.
Yeah. Like why? Like if I'm gonna go, because the only time I'm gonna do that is when I go in for a hug. So you tell me that first, as I start to, I have to be like, and then hug, or I gotta do it when I'm coming back out. I don't know. It just no.
You know what we should bring back? Well, I don't know. People might not like it because of COVID. Is the old French hello where you're like, mwah, mwah. Like anytime I've worked with French, like, people at work.
It's like a French or like Italian.
They probably
it's more
do
of like
it
a
too.
European thing.
Yeah. Whenever I work with Europeans at work, like pre-COVID, I got lots of kisses at work and I was like, and they know that they freak out. They know that Americans get put off by it because we don't know what to do, but they still do it because they're kind of like, one, like, I'm just going to keep my customs, even though I'm in America, which is like, good for you. Two, I also know that they just want to see how we react to it, because I've had a few people, they're like, Angela, it's so good to see you. And I'm like,
see,
like,
I
don't know what to do.
I wouldn't care. The thing that would get me would be if I'm used to them greeting me that way, I might eventually get into the habit of turning my head.
I push
side
my
to side
cheek
for
in.
It.
I push my cheek in, but I don't kiss them back. And then I'm like, is that rude?
See, my thing
I'm not
is,
kissing back.
I get the feeling that I might get too used to it, to the point where it's going to end up happening where our faces are going to go the same direction and they're just going to peck me on the lips twice.
There was an agency lady that I pretty much almost. Like, yeah. That happened. It was an agency lady. I started getting too confident in my like hello kissing skills that I like pretty much almost kissed her on the lips. And we were like, oh, and I was like, I'm sorry. I don't know how to do this. What am I doing? I'm out of my comfort zone.
Sorry.
So anywho, well, okay. So there's families that kiss on the lips and it's just, you know, to each his own. It just wasn't, that's not how I was raised. I'm not saying it's wrong. But I'm saying that the way that Tom Brady kisses his family is kind of weird. So, okay. So this, I found this article that came out on, it came out in February of 2018, right? So this is old. I don't know how I didn't see this, but it, it's from Newsweek, but it said during an episode of his new Facebook docuseries that he had, he's seen kissing his 11-year-old son on the mouth. So it's, yeah, and then it says, yeah, if that itself isn't a revelation, the 40-year-old NFL star was photographed last February kissing his father on the mouth during a celebration. But the kiss comes with context that makes it feel even weirder. So basically in this episode, he's getting a massage at his house. He's like laying on a massage table on his back. And his son, I guess, like comes in the room and he asks him if he can check his like fantasy football scores or something. And so Brady's like,
that's so weird.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. You can do it. Like, what am I going to get in return? If you know, and then Jack, his son, like kisses him and he tries to walk away. And then I guess, so then apparently, according to this, Brady says, that was like a peck. Okay. From the massage table, his son comes back, kisses him again, this time on the mouth. And he stays in place for like 3 seconds before standing up and walking out again while wiping his mouth with his t-shirt. So one, he's kissing his kid. He makes his kid kiss him on the mouth, but also his kid doesn't want to. And whether that's just because the cameras are on or what, yeah, like if he's wiping his mouth after, the kid's clearly like not comfortable with it. Like, I don't know, but it could just be because the cameras are on. But these are the, so I just heard this it was on the Christina P podcast. They were talking about it. So that's why I had to show this to you. But like, okay, so this is the picture. That's his son.
Well, he's just getting a massage.
While he's getting a massage. Like, what the fuck? Look at this one. He's got his hand around his kid's head.
I don't know.
And then here's him. I think that's the one. Yeah, him kissing his dad. That's so weird, dude. His dad's eyes are open too. You're not supposed to open your eyes like while you're kissing someone. That's like number one no-no. Right? Like his eyes are open, it looks like. Okay, that's normal. Like, there's his wife. Leave Tom Brady's mouth kisses alone.
And I like how,
the title
and
I like of that how
the,
one.
The photo that they use is him kissing his wife, not him kissing like his dad or his son or whatever. I don't know. Yeah, that's just odd to me.
Here's a collage of everyone he likes to kiss. Okay.
His dad are really going at it in that middle, that very middle one. Like
that, I think they said is the coach. Smushy. No, that's the coach.
That's Bill Belichick.
Is that's Belichick? Wait,
he fucking makes out with Bill Belichick.
That's probably why Belichick is so pissed at him. He's like, "Who am I gonna kiss now?"
Yeah, he's like, "You kissed me. How are you? How are we gonna?"
Belichick.
Nobody can. Who cares?
Dude, that is. Ew, look at this lady does not want to kiss Belichick. She's like, oh, get me out of here.
Hold on. Where's this one? Back out of this. Where's this photo where it looks like he's like about to whisper in his ear something very sensual?
Where? Look at that.
Your mouse was right
Ew.
On.
Ew. I'm going to kiss you so hard after this.
That or almost looks like he's like biting his cheek. So weird.
It's have we uncovered photo. He is biting his cheek.
So we're just like
Dylan, he's biting his cheek. Look at this. That's skin.
Attaboy, Brady.
Is that not skin pulling out?
That looks like it. No, that might just be the blur of like someone behind them.
No, that's his skin. He's it's biting like his him. Skin. He's a vampire. Who is this?
owner. Yeah, see, I don't even care anymore, though. This is like, eh, cool.
This Brady, is just too much.
Brady That's kisses like, people on the lips. That's his thing. Cool.
Did Tom Brady kiss Bill Belichick on the lips? Well, it sure looks like it from this photo.
Maybe that's just how he gets his weird superpower cannon arm.
Snoops.com. No, maybe that's how he gets a super. Well, he clearly, it's not a superpower to win because he just won without Belichick. Tom Brady has kissed a lot of people during his 6 Super Bowl celebrations, but was head coach Bill Belichick one of them? This is from Snoops.com.
Snopes.
Okay. Snopes.
Yeah.
Snoops. Oh, Snopes. Boring. A photograph shows quarterback Tom Brady kissing New England Patriots head coach Bill Belichick on the lips. Rating says false. It's false. How is that false? An odd amount of attention has been paid to the lips of New England Patriots quarterback.
Yeah, blah, blah, blah. When internet so when users encountered a photograph showing him kissing head coach on the lips, they were prone to believe that it was authentic. Oh, what, they accidentally bumped into each other?
It starts circulating after Brady won
4th championship.
Oh, so is this not, is it not real?
Apparently not. I don't know. There's too much reading.
That's what. So it's Belichick kissing this one woman that clearly doesn't want to kiss him.
Oh, and Brady kissing
his daughter. Wait, no. So there's Belichick kissing his daughter, but can we say, like, why are you kissing your grown ass daughter on the lips? That hard.
I don't know.
I mean, I guess they just won, so it's like, I'm so happy. But I mean, you could do that in a big hug.
That's what Tom Brady's going to do to his kid when his kid's all grown up. Stop
kissing your family on the mouth. What the frick?
Even though you just said there's nothing wrong with it, it's just not what I do. Now you're over here just like, what the fuck?
I'm sorry. It does weird me out. This weirds me out. What's going on at your house?
It's raining. And there's some thunder and stuff. It's funny because the way that the rain just like, it almost sounded like it was just a hose that was going from side to side just now. And I was like, what the fuck? It was kind of funny.
Well, now we know.
You see me looking up, that's what it is.
It's rain.
Oh, that was a good one.
Which one? The one of his daughter going, no!
Donald Trump says Bill Belichick, once kissed.
I have to say that one is actually pretty good. Okay, so we know it's photoshopped. Womp, yeah. Womp. Man, well, I'm glad because that was way too juicy.
Yeah, no, obviously he only kisses his immediate family.
Well, while they were talking about it, on the Christina P thing, she went, okay, so Nadav uncovers this little nugget about Christina that we did not know.
She kisses her kids on the lips?
No. It's even weirder. Hold on.
Is it the floss thing?
Nope, it's not the floss thing.
Because the floss thing is pretty nasty.
Oh, no. No, give me one moment because I have to. Okay. So they were talking about the same thing that we're watching.
Mm-hmm.
And then Nadav sells Christina out.
But yeah, I never. You got to turn it up.
Gosh darn it. Okay.
Related to, unlike you, Christina.
So he goes, I've never kissed anyone on the mouth that I'm related to except for you. Have you seen this, Dylan? You haven't seen it yet?
No, I didn't. I haven't watched it yet.
When you admitted to open mouth kissing your cousin?
I once Frenched my...
It's true!
I don't even know how he's related to us, quite honestly. He's like a cousin of a cut removed.
Yeah, okay. Kind of thing. But not your first.
She's like trying so hard to be nice too.
I only have female first cousins. Okay.
And that's why you've never kissed a first cousin?
Yeah. That's why.
Guys.
Dude,
listen,
she's so perturbed by this.
Days,
yeah, she's like, I don't want to talk about this, but let me try and make it slightly better for me.
The aristocrats would marry their cousins, okay? The royal family would marry their cousins.
Okay, but I have to say, sure. For something that's that embarrassing to admit, Christina owning up to this, I have to give you props because that is an embarrassing thing. But they go on to say, and they're like, well, like, how old were you when it happened?
Oh, no.
Okay, it was not a big deal.
Like 24.
I'm not an aristocrat.
She was in Hungary or any something, hot cousins? I guess.
I got hot cousins.
They're pretty. They're pretty.
She's like, do you guys have any hot cousins? You can tell how embarrassed she is. Like,
I was 18, okay?
What?
That makes it worse.
That makes it worse.
It was 1995.
I thought you were going to say I was four.
I was four.
Well, actually, that would be weird.
That would
be
just like...
Yeah, you French, your, like, you French your second cousin at four.
But you know, when you're younger, like, you don't realize, oh, we're related.
When you're 18,
this is not
know.
Okay.
Yeah, I kind
of
did. Because that's the
now?
First time we met and we were all in Hungary.
Oh, okay. I get it.
No,
get
you
it.
Don't
Hungary's
get it.
A different
no.
place. Like,
no. 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 No.
Oh, my gosh.
If it was her step cousin, I would not be judgmental.
Now, see, now I
but
gotta.
But if we think that there is any type of lineage in this,
now I need to make sure I watch that tomorrow because yeah, I'm behind on a lot of stuff. I got swamped at work recently, so
you got swamped.
Swamped.
Yeah, yeah. So I had to share that one with you because I was like, oh, because like I don't know, like. Or have you ever had like the thing where like you were saying like, oh, you'd be afraid of like accidentally kissing someone on the mouth. Like, I think I only had a weird encounter like that with like mom and dad each maybe like one time where like you accidentally go the wrong way and you accidentally kiss them on the mouth and you're like, oh, and even like with your own parent, you're like, oh my God, that was
so
weird.
Yeah, see, I never really like kissed mom and dad on the cheek or anything like that. So I don't think I ever had that problem.
Oh, I guess I don't know. I'm just
like, eh, I give you a hug.
This is all you
Although
got.
I did have really just awkward incidents in general. There was a time where I was riding with a friend of mine. We had gotten like Subway or something. Mm-hmm. And as we're riding, I go over a speed bump. And I didn't realize that her lid, when they gave her the drink, wasn't on all the way. And it splashed up. And it splashed on her. And she was like, oh my God, Dylan, do you have napkins? And I'm like, oh, I'm so sorry. And I like grabbed the napkins.
Who was that?
It was just one of my friends.
Oh.
Back in the day.
Oh.
And I started to like pat her dry. And then I was like, oh shit, I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
And she's just like, what the fuck? Yeah, just give me the napkins. And I'm like, I'm so sorry. That's right, Aiko. It was bad. I was like, I'm so sorry.
Dude,
I didn't mean to
crazy.
Do that. Yeah, I was like, oh my God, there's a spill. I'm so sorry. Here, napkins, clean it up. Like, I got in that mindset.
You just gotta react.
Well, that's, I know you that's said, unfortunately how I usually operate in situations like that. I'm just like
Aiko.
Aiko knows. She's agreeing with me. She's like, he does that. He definitely does that.
He definitely does that. All right, it's your turn to share stuff. I know you got things.
All right, so I'm not sure if you know, but recently the Mortal Kombat movie came out. A new
yeah.
Mortal Kombat movie came out.
Is it good?
It's free on HBO Max if mm-hmm. you have it. So
it is?
Watch it. Yeah. Like it's in theaters, okay. But you can also watch it for free on HBO Max.
Mm-hmm.
So one thing about movies and myself is I'm not a critic. I don't sit there and like really look at stuff and be like, oh, I don't like the way that they did this. I don't like the way that the story really went here for the most part. I just... When I watch movies, usually I just sit there and like make my mind go blank and I enjoy it. And I'm just like, oh, cool. Like that's why I always have a hard time when people ask me, oh, did you like that movie? I'm like, well, yeah, I enjoyed it. Cause that's just how I watch movies. Like I shut my brain off and I just enjoy, like it could be the worst movie ever. And I'm still just like, that was an awesome movie. And everyone else is like, what the fuck? Did we watch the same movie?
Yeah.
So there have been some people that are like, you know, like it wasn't that good. Like, you know, story inconsistencies, who gives a shit? Like the reason why I wanted to watch it was the fighting to see whatever like references they made to the Mortal Kombat games, which like, you know, they had the get over here with Scorpion yeah. and they had like super dope Sub-Zero stuff. And like, also, like I said, the fighting, because I'm a super big martial arts movie head. I freaking love martial arts movies so much. And one thing about the
I'm so sorry, Dylan. Hold on one second. I'm sorry. Hold on one second. Hold on.
Oh my goodness. And it's got to be during my time too that this happens. I feel like she planned this because she always gets, when we usually have phone calls, she gets very bored when I start talking about anything I enjoy, like video games or movies, or this one I do on purpose is I'll talk about my work because she just doesn't get it. And she'll just be like, no. And I'm like, yeah, exactly. So,
okay, are you there?
Okay. So ready? One of the main things, which is how I'm going to get into this whole thing, is the character or the actor that played Sub-Zero. His name is Joe Taslim.
Mm-hmm.
And he, super, super awesome, like martial artist. Let me share. I got all the IMDb's up and stuff.
Oh, you get to share with me now.
That's right. I get to share with you now. So, you know, that's him. This was him looking like Sub-Zero. Like, they did such an awesome job with like all of the Sub-Zero special effects and stuff. What? Like, it looked super sweet. And he was in another movie, which this is a movie that whenever I talk to people about martial arts films, I bring it up since I first saw it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one that I'm always very adamant about having people watch.
Uh-huh.
And it was a movie that he was in, and it's this one right here called The Raid Redemption. So
Never seen it. I don't like action films. This is a hard sell, Dylan.
Yeah, that's why I said you're either going to be like, oh, that's all right, or you are probably just going to zone out this entire time because The Raid Redemption is such a good freaking movie. That's also, if you look at my backdrop, this
is that what
is,
that's from?
I believe this is a like a temple or some like really old structure in Indonesia. The Raid Redemption is an Indonesian film. And this
is it from The Raid Redemption, or it's just a place
no,
in
it's,
India? No,
it's just a place in Indonesia.
Oh, that's a real place?
Yes,
behind you?
In Indonesia, not India. And so the Raid Redemption, which is funny because it sounds like it's like the Raid 2 or something, which there is a Raid 2. That movie's also super fucking great. But the Raid Redemption is basically a like police unit in Indonesia is going in and they're trying to raid this building of this like, you know, drug traffic like gangster. So it's supposed to be like a 30-story building and like they do all of their operations in there. And yeah, it's like this giant team of SWAT dudes. They're supposed to go in, take down this organization. And that's the whole movie. So the movie stars Joe Taslim. He is the brother of the main character. Then we have the actual main character, Iko Uwais. This guy, so good. Him and then one of the guys that plays Mad Dog.
What is a Mad
Dog? Yayan Ruhain. I'm probably butchering all of their names, but I hope they know that I have utmost respect for these guys because they are so freaking awesome. So this guy, he plays the bad guy in the movie. As a matter of fact, he is such a good freaking character and martial artist that they brought him back in the Raid 2 as a separate character because, you know, obviously something, his character dies off in the end of the first movie, but like,
and they like revive him as someone else.
Yeah, they're like, this guy is too good for us not to have, to the point where like these guys blew up because apparently specifically because of the Raid movie, they blew up to the point where they started being like really well known. And in the first of those most recent Star Wars films that came out,
yeah,
this was them in it. Like
they come as a package now.
They had a very small cameo, which is why this article is definitely
nice.
I agree.
Little nod.
They definitely wasted these guys' talents. Like it would have been so awesome if they had to do some crazy martial arts in Star Wars, but unfortunately, Star Wars isn't about martial arts. But yeah, no, like they had them. So yeah, that's our main man. That's Mad Dog. And then this guy in the back here is another, he's another actor.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, they don't have a picture of him on his IMDb, which I need to find a way to remedy that. Sisep Arif Rahman.
Mm-hmm.
This is an actual picture of him in The Raid 2. Mm-hmm. So he shows up in the second movie. Yeah. Oh, all these movies are just so good.
Is The Raid in English or is it subtitles?
No, it's subtitled.
Oh, I don't know.
Which is another thing. No, don't fucking awe me. Fucking nut up, be a real adult,
and watch a nut.
Watch a flipping foreign film. Foreign films are awesome.
These
movies are so great. They are so good. Oh my gosh.
I have to read.
I don't care.
I have to pay attention and I have to read.
You're starting to sound like Bert right now. I hope you realize that. I'm the Tom in this situation and you're the Bert. Yeah, no. These movies are so good.
You're the Bert.
So then I'm guessing because of the fact that they got noticed and were put in Star Wars, Sisep and Yayan in particular, these two guys, then like they apparently got found out to the point where they were put in John Wick 3. And they were like these like crazy assassins that kept coming after John Wick that he did not kill. Yeah, the two of them. Which I was like, oh, what? John Wick didn't murder these guys? They have like that mutual respect where they're like, yo, John Wick, we gonna let you go? And he's like, nah, I'm gonna let you go.
Isn't John Wick about a guy that goes for revenge because someone killed his dog?
That's right. One of the greatest, one of the greatest love stories ever told.
I mean, I would kill someone if they killed Iko, but
it was a present from his deceased wife. So not only has your wife
your dog
has passed away, and this is the last gift she gave to you. Now this living being that was a gift is now gone. Like, you're gonna lose your mind and you're gonna turn into the Russian boogeyman and murder everybody.
The Russian boogeyman.
Action movies. So my whole point was this. These guys are super awesome.
Mm-hmm.
And we're now going to watch a clip from the hallway fight scene because this is so good. It's so good. So that's our boy. He's coming in. He's trying to escape because obviously at the very beginning of the movie. Yeah, it's
just
their whole SWAT team. There's no sound for you coming through.
No. Is there music though? It might be better to do it. You're doing a really good job at explaining it. If there's music.
There might be music.
Okay. Explain it. Go ahead.
You don't need to hear anything. So yeah, him and the SWAT team, they get attacked very fast. Uh-oh. Because while it is like an apartment building, literally the whole thing is filled with this like drug empire dude's bodyguards. And
how are we getting away?
Indonesia, these guys don't fuck around. They got machetes. Like, they're going to kill you old-fashioned style. Good old rip the flesh, salt the wound. So that's why he sees this and he's just like, all right, fuck it. We're going to fight. Oh, my goodness.
No!
Just watch him beat the crap out of these dudes.
Oh, good. No blood.
Oh, good.
Okay, that's nice. I can't watch action. My ADD goes like, what?
Yeah, see, but that's okay. Because I'm so happy and
oh my god, so much going
like
on.
It's so good. Just popping that dude. I have to remember what the martial art is that they're using because the two guys that were in John Wick and then this guy right here are practitioners of it, and I want to say one of them apparently taught the Indonesian like secret service, like presidential guard. He taught them how to fight using that martial arts style back in like 1990. And the other guy is like one of the oldest martial arts masters / practitioners. This is also really great. This is one of the best parts and it's going to cut right before it happens. He slams that dude right onto that busted door on the bottom and you just hear like the crack and you're like, oh, it's so good.
I can't do the action
out of me.
But that was good.
It's so much and it's so good.
Maybe I'll watch it when I have nothing to do.
You should tell Will to watch it because
he doesn't like subtitles.
You don't even have to watch it with the subtitles. Honestly, like it's mainly action. It's super awesome action.
Okay.
And also tell him, don't be a child, fucking read a book.
Okay, you can tell him that.
But yeah, no, these guys are awesome. So yeah, so Yayan, this guy, yeah, he was the one that he apparently trained like the Indonesian like secret presidential service
in the movie?
Salat.
So in the movie?
No, like in real life.
Oh.
So yeah, it's called Pencak Salat is the martial art, the main martial art used in that movie. And then yeah, this Sisep, this guy is like one of I want to say he's one of like the oldest living masters of Salat. Yeah, no. Oh. That movie's great. The Raid 2 is great. There's like, they got a chick that just runs around swinging a hammer everywhere. Mm-hmm. She's popping people's skulls. It is like, oh, they're such good movies. And then don't even get me started. So then if you want to see some other action stuff, there's my man, Ong Bak. Ong Bak is great. I could talk about these action movies forever. Like,
ugh, it's killing me.
Yeah, I know.
It's but killing me.
You have to understand, Angela, martial arts is like, that's what I grew up on. You stole the Legend of Drunken Master VHS copy that we had back in the day when you first moved out. It. What?
What, the one with, Jackie Chan. Yeah, I got that.
Are you kidding me?
Well, no one was watching it at mom's house.
Do you know how many years I've been looking for that? That VHS?
I'll send it to you.
Oh my gosh. That was one of my like all-time favorite because that was like also one of the only ones we
owned. You could also like, buy it for yourself.
Yeah, I could, but we already had it and at I'll mom's house we you. Had a VHS. Cuz I remember
VHS? No, I don't have the VHS. I have a DVD.
Okay. Because no, I was gonna say,
I only have Shanghai Noon. I have like whatever we had on DVD. No, I don't have that. See, one then.
Shouldn't even know what. Cause yeah, I'm pretty sure I'd asked you multiple times. I was like, Angela, are you sure you don't have it? And you're like, yeah, no, I don't have it. I was like,
I have a DVD. Sure. I think it's just Shanghai Noon.
I was like, I'm pretty sure you watched it as you went to sleep one night. Cause you're like, I need something boring that'll put me to sleep, but that'll still stay on the TV.
Yeah.
And yeah, I used to love those movies. Cause yeah, like it was that we had Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. We had like Jet Li the One or Kiss of the Dragon. Martial arts films are so good. They're so good.
They're not for me.
Keanu Reeves.
But I'm glad that you like them.
In another martial arts movie called Tai Chi. It was like Tai Chi Warrior or something. That was a good movie. Oh. Martial arts films are just so good. I love them. Then there's Boyka.
Boyka.
I'm trying to remember what the actual movie series is called, because it starts off with this, like, I want to say he was like a boxer and he gets thrown in jail. I don't remember why. And so they have him, like the whole movie is him getting ready to fight this other dude, this like Russian guy named Boyka, for some like crazy underground like prison fight.
Fight club.
He gets his ass beat the first time, then, you know, crazy training montage, he comes back, beats him, but then there are four other movies after that, and the other three movies are all about the guy that was the bad guy in that first movie. So then it basically becomes the Boyka saga, because yeah, it's just this dude who I think he's British in real life, but yeah, he's just some white dude pretending to be a Russian guy, just beating the crap out of people in Russian prison. And it's awesome. And there's actually a famous move that he does in this movie. See, now I'm like so excited.
My excited. Brain is so bored right now. I don't know why I can't do action. I wish I liked it. I hate it with a passion.
So the guy that plays Boyka is named Scott Adkins, which she was in some other movies called like Ninja.
Boring.
And like Ninja 2. And I was like, boring. You're a white guy in a movie called Ninja. It was kind of weird, but they were still good. I still enjoy them because, you know, it's just martial arts and karate and stuff.
There's a little martial arts.
I need to find where this kick is. So apparently this move was invented by, I want to say it was a Japanese stunt actor in one of their like superhero movies or like TV series called Guyver.
MacGyver?
No, just Guyver. But what ends up happening is he does this like crazy elaborate jump, and then he does this like splits. Okay. I just found it. Oh my goodness. Oh, I'm so excited. This one isn't even bad. It's more of just like, it is an amazing feat that this guy pulls off. And like, I've watched videos before of him talking about it. 'Cause he's like, yeah, no, this isn't like something you would actually ever see happening. This is just for show. So it's not this one, but it's going to be this next one right here. That
Jesus.
So yeah, he does like,
so
a,
he goes over it like and then kicks flip. Him with the one below.
So, yeah,
he's
so
kicking
he,
over the guy's head and then over his the guy's foot head, on the and bottom then, kicks yeah, him. And then what, as in the face? Left,
yeah, and then as the left foot is coming down, yeah, he notches that and then just bop, right
oh,
in the face.
Oh, that's fucked.
I'm like, that's
and then
what so
does he
cool.
do? Does he land on his back? Where's he landing?
Yeah, and then he just lands on his ass.
Because the other guy is already come out. Because he's like, what the fuck just happened? Because the guy's probably thinking, you missed me, dumbass.
Yeah,
and then
exactly. Because, yeah, he ducked over the first one, starts to come back up, and then just gets kicked in the face. And I was like, oh, that's so cool.
I don't know how someone could think of that in that short amount of time.
And, yeah, that's why they call it, I think they call it the Boyka kick now, because that was the movie that he did it in that made it famous. But, yeah, he talked about how the stunt guy that originally performed that, I think, was the stunt coordinator or like the action fight coordinator for that movie. Mm-hmm. And he was the one that was like, oh, yo, you should use this. And then he basically gave him permission to like have and use that as his move.
Oh, it was someone else's move.
That's what I said earlier. Oh, wow. Yeah, see, this is exactly what I knew was going to happen, but it's okay. I prepared for it.
I'm trying really hard.
No, you're not. Not hard
I'm
enough.
Trying.
Oh, but yeah, no, like, because it's crazy feats like that. So I've also seen videos, because once I start down the martial arts rabbit hole, I just go deep. This guy has actually perfected the move now to the point where he can do it and still land on his feet. And I'm like, what?
Okay, so here's your homework. I want you to go practice that. And next time you want to talk to me about martial arts, you got to be able to do that before we start talking about it.
I really need to. I've always wanted to, and I really do need to start. I don't know what in particular.
Find a dojo.
Yeah, in Florida.
Yeah, find a Florida dojo. A flojo.
Yeah. Flojo. Nah, I don't like all that flow grown and all that weird salt life. So that's
I live
not
by
even,
salt life.
Do you live by salt life? Are you surrounded by nothing but water?
I eat salt on everything.
No, salt life is like the adult version of tap out. So you remember all the people that wore tap out back in the day?
Oh, like the bros?
Yeah. They're,
oh, there's like
they're
a,
now,
a brand they're now, called Salt Life?
They're now salt lifers. That's basically what happens. You go from wearing tap out
sounds
to then
like
having
some bloated
salt
ass
life,
people
to having Salt Life stickers. Yeah,
looking bloated AF with your Salt Life t-shirts. Have fun with that. Goodness.
Actually, I don't know. I don't even know if they actually have Salt Life t-shirts. Let's find out. I hate it so much. I see so many cars.
Would people say that, or they have like bumper stickers that say Salt Life?
No, it's like a it's not like a bumper sticker. It's usually on their like window. But yeah, it's when you see the people get out of their car, this is what they have. And they look just like you can picture them younger,
It looks like Fear and Loathing writing.
And they're definitely like wearing tap out clothing when you picture them younger.
God, why do people have such horrible taste in things?
I don't know. It's like, yeah, it's just.
That is the ugliest font I've ever seen. Yeah, Salt Life. Look where Salt Life got you, in the slammer.
Yeah, it took me a while too at first to figure out what that was. I was like, Salt Life. I was like, is this like some, is this some weird, like the video games took over? And they're like, haha, you're salty, the Salt Life. And then I realized once I started, I saw a couple trucks. Because it was mainly trucks that had it. And I was like, that's kind of confusing, though. I don't picture video game nerds driving trucks that often. No. And then the first time I saw one pulling a boat and then another one pulling jet skis, I was like, oh, these are people that are like, I fucking live on the ocean. Woo. Actually, that's more California. But yeah.
Dude, the things behind you, those little mountains, look like two little horns coming up out of your head.
These aren't mountains. These are structures.
What? Those two structures. But put your head back. It looks like two little horns coming up.
It goes with my mustache, one on each side.
Well, do you have anything else to share? If not, I have something to close this out with. Oh, did you have anything?
Watch The Raid.
I leave you with this final plea. Watch The Raid.
Watch it. Well, I'll even look up where you can watch it for all you people out there, because you need to watch this movie. And I heard that cough. Don't even hit me with that cough right now. You can watch it on Tubi, whatever that is.
Oh,
I don't care.
We have Tubi. It's free. Tubi is free. Tubi's free. I think it's Tubi.
What is Tubi?
I think we have Tubi. I think it's free. I don't know. We have something.
Tubi from Nier Automata. That's a whole other thing. No, don't worry about it. No, just to be.
We've been watching The Surreal Life from like the early 2000s.
See, this is when I get to like zone out. She gets to talk about it, and I get to be like, oh yeah, so wait, this? And you'll be like,
you're way better at pretending like you're interested in it.
I've had to do it my whole life. I'm excellent.
Well, okay.
But yeah, no, honestly, I don't care. Don't watch it for free. Buy this flipping movie. Okay. Support these dudes. It's great. It's so great. Watch it.
Well, I got.
So anyway, what were you saying?
Oh, I got something to send us. I got two things to send us out. One is, as I said last week about Dr. Drew being annoying as hell, this came up.
Love it so much.
You haven't even seen it, or did you see it yet?
I haven't seen it. It literally popped up like 3 hours ago.
Oh, well, I'm a Fupa Troopa, so, or actually our YouTube channel is a Fupa Troopa, so I can give you the sign.
Yeah, of course
in.
We are.
So Dr. Drew is trying to break up Ethan and Trisha.
Of course he is.
It's from Reddit, right?
Okay, get this.
I don't know what it's from. I don't know. I never know who to give credit to. I'm like, is this from
I just told you. It's in Xena Princess Warrior. You did the hashtag, Xena Princess Warrior.
It's Trisha's birthday. She's a Taurus.
Yeah, he told me that.
I'm like, a Taurus, so we would get along well.
I love the memes.
Dr.
Now.
Drew is trying it's to break up. Us up again.
Yeah, okay. Here you go.
Oh, yeah. What's with that?
Dr. Drew's the enemy of the show.
Enemy of the show.
We love Dr. Drew. I love enemy Dr. of the
he show. I tweeted you a very nice birthday message from my heart. Oh. I said, I'm honored and privileged to call Trisha my friend. She's an amazing person full of wit, insight, and grit. I mean, literally, lots of grit. Like
lots
sand?
Of grit.
No, I'm just kidding. Grit means coarse. Like you're strong.
Dang. Yeah.
She has, without a doubt, made me a better
it's
person
so nice
for knowing her. That's
days.
True, actually.
It's so nice to see them.
And happy
along.
Birthday week, bestie. So you're like, oh, yeah, we're having such a good connect. We're having
like,
in a really good place, right?
Yeah, we are.
Dr.
We thought,
Drew be
they
like,
it, we're like
I think you guys need my help again. I'm
so, didn't seem
did
like
you see that?
No, because I was
you just missed
to,
it.
Because, yeah, because they're like, they started off as people that butt heads, and normally those people don't become friends. But they've worked at it enough.
Yeah, like a
that's
true
hilarious.
Relationship.
I think you need my help again. Yeah, they've
yeah,
worked
so, so this
on
that's
it.
True, actually. And happy
it.
Birthday.
They're like, they're good friends now.
Yeah, exactly. Wait, listen really quick.
Week bestie. So you're like, oh, we're having such a good connect. We're having in a really good place, right?
Yeah, we are.
Dr.
We
Drew be like, I think you guys need my help again. I'm sorry, Dr. Drew. Are you trying to break us up? Like, please.
Well,
yeah. Ethan sees right through it.
Also, Ethan looked like he had a bunch of that cake all over his face.
I know
the green splotches are just part of the makeup, but like it looked like the like icing from that cake just all over his face, which honestly the stuff near his mouth could have been. I don't know.
No, sometimes that stuff is messy. It's the Beetlejuice stuff.
Don't say his name that many
times.
You
gotta watch. You
said it twice.
Anymore.
Yeah, no.
Okay, yeah. No more. But yeah, it's pretty good. If you haven't watched Frenemies, I don't know why you're here. And then lastly, our cousin, who says she's going to start watching us soon, which I got excited about, sent me this nugget that I forgot about, which, close your eyes for a second while I cue this up. Close your little eyes.
Older or younger cousin?
Alexis sent me this today.
I mean, you could have just said younger. I would have known. Oh,
okay. Are you ready? She sent me this.
She doesn't want her name on it.
And it's a little snip. No, wait. It's a little snippet from H3 from a show that they did where they had someone do like those deep fake. Remember all the deep fake stuff? Like people can make anyone on the internet say anything. So, okay. Are you ready? Watch. Open your eyes. I do the number. Oh, wait. Oh, fuck.
Oh, good for you.
And it's Ethan. Have you not seen this? Oh my god, okay, I'll start from the beginning. So it's Ethan as Kevin and it's Ela as Holly, but they look so real and it's so such a testament to their relationship. It's so good.
Good for you.
It looks just like her. Dude,
you want an M&M?
Oh, no, that is so sweet. Thank you though. Yeah.
I keep them here at my desk so that everybody doesn't eat them.
It's so good.
That is a very safe place for them.
I just love that he thought he was like special
the
whole time.
Dude, you gotta watch this last part. Are you ready?
Bang.
Yeah. Ela.
Wait, you missed it.
I heard the Ela. Ela.
I didn't realize that he did that. I thought he actually said Ela and had to rewind it.
She is cute and helpful and she bang.
Ela.
She is cute.
Oh.
I am totally gonna bang.
Yeah.
She is cute and helpful. Yeah. And she really seems into me.
I can't believe you haven't seen that before. Dude, it's like so good. But it's like a testament because he's just this like schlub and she's just so good to him.
Did you ever watch the dance video that Tom and Bert made?
No.
Oh shit. We cannot end this show before you see this.
Dance video.
Oh my goodness. So Bert, see, this super sucks that we can't. I mean, it's good that I can't get music out because like it's they both have people's songs during it, but yeah, I guess it's better that way. So Bert had a tour that he basically like announced with this, which I think this was the tour that I'd gotten tickets for that COVID happened and then I wasn't able to go, or it hasn't happened yet. So Bert makes this video to announce his tour dates. And he took some hip hop dancing.
Pause it really quick. Is it optimized? So who's this girl? Just some dancer?
So that was his dance instructor.
Oh, okay.
And yeah, cause that was for his Body Shots world tour. Never mind. This was the tour before the one I was supposed to see.
No way.
So originally they were supposed to do a hip hop dance battle for their Sober October that they do with Joe Rogan and their other comedian friend Ari Shaffir, but I guess Joe and Ari were like, no, we don't want to do this. So Bert was like, fuck it, I'm gonna do it myself, it's gonna be awesome. So yeah, he did it.
Dude, he looks like when like you go to your kid's recital. Oh no, that's not like a kid's
it's
recital.
It's so great. I love it.
Like it felt like, yes, and yeah, and then he just has all his shows with the credits.
Yeah, and the credits,
dude,
are just
that's
all his
dope
shows.
That's pretty good.
So he does that. Then because of it, Tom watches this and he goes, this is shit. He goes, Bert can't dance. I could do so much better.
Is this before Tom like fucked himself up?
Yes, this is before Tom fucked himself up.
It's called karma.
So.
So what, he tried to dance?
So Tom tried to dance. Tom did dance.
Not he's better. Is he better dance, than Bert?
He's so much better. So these girls are just talking shit. They're like, this is awful. Look at him. He can't dance. Look at his tits. He's so fat.
Oh, no.
Oh, that's nasty.
Oh, poor Bert.
That's so gross. I don't know how he has a wife. His poor wife.
Oh,
this guy's
no.
definitely racist. Probably that's smells too. Yeah. Hey, Tom Segura. And then Tom just turns around. He's been dancing his whole life.
I filmed in that warehouse.
Did you?
Yeah, for Chevy. That's where they did This Is America, too. Yeah. Oh, my God. What is he doing?
So Tom dropped.
What is he? He's not better. What is this?
Whoa, hold on. Hold on. You got to watch.
Oh.
Yeah. You got to hold up. My boy can dance. And so the way this all connects is the deep fakes. And this is it right here.
He uses a deep fake? No. Yeah. No. Did Bert know he did this? Did Bert know he did this?
So what happened was they're shooting Two Bears, One Cave. And the guy that Tom got to direct this, he says, fuck you, Bert, right there. But the guy that he got to direct this, he came in and what Tom told him was, oh, hey, we're going to do some, we're going to do.
Why is he killing Bert? And then there's his tour dates.
Yeah. It's so good.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, so what he did was
he's a monster.
He told Bert that they were gonna, because you know obviously this was when they were doing tours and stuff.
Yeah.
He was like, hey, in case we need you to do a ad read, we're gonna scan your face so that way we can just like always have you, even if like you don't happen to be here. And
he said yes to this, like not like why. That's ridiculous. Of course he said yes,
because he trusts Tom, and he's just like, oh yeah, okay, we can do that. So he asked Tom, he's like, oh hey, so are you gonna be here the whole time? Or he goes, oh no, like I need to go home and feed Ellis or like do something with his son real quick.
Yeah.
He goes, but yeah, I'll end up being back so I can do it. He lied to him, which when he shows Bert this, Bert gets so pissed off. Not at the video or any of that. He loved the video. He loved him being stabbed. What he was upset about was the fact that Tom lied to him that he didn't come back and do it himself. He's like, you asshole. He goes, I was sitting there for hours and you freaking, your guy's like, okay, look sad, look happy. And you're just like, he's like, fuck, you're gonna be able to make me look like I did all this terrible shit now because you have my face. He's like, oh fake. Yeah. He's like, I can ruin your whole career now and it's gonna be great.
Oh my God. Those things are dangerous.
And then yeah, he talked about how they they had the audition for Bert. And they're like, yeah, we had like a bunch of big fat dudes and we're like, no.
They could pick the largest man.
And yeah, they got that shirt that just said machine, because that's Bert's story, which he's getting a movie made of right now. Him and
he's
Mark Hamill.
He's not going to rehab. He's having a movie done.
Yeah, him and Mark Hamill. So
it's gonna be horrible.
It's
gonna be so bad.
I was so stoked when all of this happened. I was like, oh my God! I'm in the middle of my office. I like threw my headphones off. Everyone's
I'm
like,
done.
Dude. Yeah, they're like, what are you doing? I'm like, this is the greatest thing ever. Shut up. Even though I have noise canceling headphones on. It was great. I loved it. I still love every minute of it.
Wow.
And yeah, they got the behind the scenes. Yeah, I want to say that like the people that Tom got, were they like Beyonce's backup dancers? I don't know. They're really good backup dancers. Like,
yeah.
They dance they dance for all the people.
Well, sometimes you look better if you have good backup dancers than you actually are.
And the other nice thing was that
Bert didn't need backup dancers.
Bert was laughing, and he's like, it was so much better. He's just like, I hate you though, because you spent so much more money than I did because I didn't know that this was going to be a thing.
Yeah. We need to do one of these.
I told one of my friends, because his sister owns like a music studio. Mm-hmm. And I was like, do they do dance stuff there? And he's like, yeah. I was like, yo,
you start learning it.
Hook me up with some hip hop dance lessons.
Yeah, let's see.
I want to make my own video.
Yeah, let's see it.
And I need to clown on both of these guys, which means I'm going to need way longer to.
That'll put us on the map. Yeah, you got to go. You got to start training now.
And I'll just lie and I'll be like, this has been in the making since Tom's. It took this long because I really suck at dancing, but now I'm a master.
I've risen above.
I've risen above. I am the dancing man. That's all I can. You know, I always have all these. I'm gonna learn some sort of martial art, and I'm gonna learn a hip hop dance. It's gonna be great.
I think you should.
So support us, so I can, do these things, and we can film.
Yeah,
and do
subscribe,
it.
Become our main queen. That would be funny. Like, subscribe, hit the bell. We have 17 subscribers now.
I need
That's
my queens.
Great.
I need my queens to support
queens?
Me in my.
Gather around, queens. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to do anything of monetary value. All you got to do is hit the like button, hit the subscribe, hit the bell. You
watch
doing
us
that
every week.
And watch us. That is all you got to do. You don't even have to give us money.
For only however long this video is, a day every week or so, you can
put on
help
while you're working.
Me
put it on while you're walking
learn,
your dog.
Learn martial arts.
While you're
arts
taking a bath.
And hip hop dance.
There you go.
Because that's what we all really want.
Yeah, I'm still doing those things.
I know I want it.
I have to pee so bad. I think this is a good time to wrap up.
This is a great time to wrap up. Bye, everybody. She's going to go pee, and I'm just going to sit here.
Thank you for watching. I thought you were going to put us out like you did last week.
Thank you for watching the Relatable Rodarte podcast starring Angela and Dylan. Tune in next week when we talk about pancakes and waffles. What's better? You tell us.